So here is a toddy shop as well, just on the way to Andaganeri. That's an amazing sunset we are having.
For my song, but I couldn't resist singing.
Some kind of a small stars for the dress. Italy. Ah, that's good.
Chai and Dad. The beach of darkness, Andhakar or Andaganeri.
Hi guys, I'm in Andaganeri Beach. This is the main tourist attraction in Alappuzha district, or one of the best beaches in Alappuzha. So this is a very beautiful place, and it has its own peculiarities. This is an area of a confluence of the seawater as well as the lake. So just behind me you can see that area, that is a confluence of the seawater as well as the lake, so it forms an estuary. The flow of water is right now towards the sea because it's a low tide, and the sea has come inwards because of this monsoon season. Otherwise there will be a lot of space over here for the tourists or the people who are visiting this beach to spend time over here. The people fly kites and all these stuffs over here, they enjoy, they're having a good time on the weekend. So it's a beautiful place, and this area was reconstructed after the tsunami in 2004. The fund which was used for the redevelopment and the reconstruction was utilized for the redevelopment of this area as well, because this is one of the area which was very much indeed hardly hit by the tsunami of 2004. And the fund was utilized and the intention was good, but the maintenance is very poor. So you can see the railings are also in a dilapidated state. These buildings which is constructed for the tourist purpose is now is in a very bad condition. See, the roofs are taken away by the wind because of non-maintenance, because there is not a single person who is guarding this position or this area. And earlier when I used to come here in that time period, there were a lot of chairs or the concrete slabs put over here for the people to sit and watch the sea. But it is also taken away. I don't know who is taking it away. Maybe it is gone as a theft. And this structure you are seeing, it was like a hut-like structure. And it is also now not there. The same way in that area also, that hut-like structure, which is only the four pillars are right now there. The hut-like structure or the entire roof is missing. And because of COVID, now this area is prohibited for entering. But I am here in the early morning, that's why I got entry. Because after that, the police person or the coastal guard people will be here. And they will be asking us you to leave this place as soon as you come over here. So I can see old person is fishing. He is trying to get his early catch. So this is all this view of this region. So why this Andaganeri beach is called as Andaganeri? Andhakar, you know, in Hindi as well as in Malayalam, Andhakar means darkness, right? Andhakar, Andaganeri. Ari is estuary. So estuary, estuary is a place where the seawater meets the lake water, and there is a flow, a heavy flow of water. So Andhakar Nadi, because this place was totally in the dark side, the people commuting or traveling or sailing through this area were left upright because there was no signal to reach in the dark hours, in the night hours. So there has so lot of accidents or mishaps happened, which has took the lives. Thus came the name Andhakar Nadi, or the estuary of darkness, or the lagoon of darkness. I'm still confused whether I should call this area as a lagoon or as an estuary, because both are more or less having the same peculiarities if you look geographically. And just I'm flipping the camera right now again. So this is the structure I was saying about. Now there is no roofs. It is totally taken away, either by the wind or by theft, it can be. So you can see the flow of water over here. It's very, very fast. It's going down. Oh, this area is also fully covered by the bushes, and there is a narrow way to just get down off this area. So this is the building which was part of all this tourist development project, but everything is in a dilapidated state. See, the lights also came down. This is the upper railings for the beach walkway, which is very, the intention was very good, but this money, the taxpayers' money, is just gone because nobody is held accountable or responsible for that. So this is a washroom for males and females, this area, but it's again not in a working condition. So ബഹുമാനപ്പെട്ട ശ്രീ തിലോത്തമൻ എം എൽ എ 2015 ആസ്തി വികസന ഫണ്ട് വിനിയോഗിച്ച് നിർമ്മിച്ച അന്ധകാർ നദി ബീച്ച്. സോ ഇറ്റ് വാസ് ബിൽറ്റ് ഓൺ 2015-16 വിത്ത് ദ ഡെവലപ്മെന്റ് ഫണ്ട് ബൈ ദ പി തിലോത്തമൻ എം എൽ എ. ഓക്കെ, ദിസ് ഈസ് സെയിങ് അബൌട്ട് ദിസ് ലൊക്കേഷൻ വിച്ച് ഈസ് ദിസ് ടോയ്ലറ്റ് കോംപ്ലെക്സ്, ആൻഡ് ദ എമൗണ്ട് ഈസ് ഷോയിങ് അസ് 38 lakhs ഫോർ ദിസ് ബിൽഡിംഗ്. So this is that construction, or this main area, nothing is there. It's totally isolated. I think earlier the fishermen used to put the fishing nets are there still. People have put their fishing nets, but the roofs and entire area is totally gone. So this is the area where we have the boats, or the fishing boats, come to get closer over here, and people take the fishes from here. So this is the flow of water from the lake towards the sea. So the water is getting away from the lake towards the sea here, and that's a kind of a small island formed here because of the sand deposits which is coming from the sea. It's fully looking like a jungle right now, this area. This is the main entrance of the Andhakar Nadi beach. See what a pathetic condition this, the high railings to have the tourists to visit this area, is fully occupied by this bushes and trees. Oh my god, it's like a ghost house right now. See how much the money is wasted. Nobody is bothered about the money which is going unutilized. So let me climb over here to see a good view. It's very difficult. See, the area is very promising area. There is a very good opportunity for the tourists. See the condition, but it is underutilized, or not even utilized properly. Oh my god, it's so beautiful area, but this building's condition is totally pathetic. So that's a lighthouse. It was constructed in 1970s around, so it's very old. Earlier, the people visitors got the opportunity to go up and see the panoramic sky view of this entire area. But right now it's functional, but the people or the visitors are not allowed because of this construction. This old, so they don't want to take the risk. So this is the lighthouse, which serves as a lighting path for the boats which venture out to the deep sea and come out late in the night. So this can give a signal to reach this area. In Kerala, I think there are 7 to 8 lighthouse ones. The near one is the Alappuzha lighthouse. So this is the lighthouse area. The officials who reside operating this lighthouse reside here. So this is under the Ministry of Shipping, Government of India, Directorate of Lighthouse and Lighthouse, Manakkodam Lighthouse. So this is the exact name of this lighthouse, Manakkodam Lighthouse. So this is coming under the Ministry of Shipping, and we have that beautiful lighthouse just staring at us. So this is a very close look up of that lighthouse. So that's it. So that's the entire stretch of Antakarneri beach, both the sides. This is the north side and that's the south side, which is to the goes to the Alappi side, and this is to the Cochin side. And this is the estuary where the sea meets the lake, and we can see that's a kind of a lagoon and a small sand deposit formed over here. People are playing, so that's a good view. So you can see the whole area here. The guys are playing football in the early morning. People are standing and waiting to catch the fish. They are just catching the fishing net and just waiting for the right moment to throw it off and get the fish trick into that. So let's go to that area a little more and see what is there. This is a classic example of how the taxpayers' money is gone underutilized or not utilized. I'm just saddened to see this kind of use, because this is a very promising area and has a lot of tourist potential, but see the condition. There is no roof above your head. I don't know how this has been taken away by the wind, because it's fully constructed very good, but still it's not properly maintained. So again, this is a place to, but I'm not sure whether I can walk, because it looks like very dilapidated and shaking also. My weight, it won't carry maybe. I'm a little scared to go through that area. So the boats, fishing boats are lying over here. So this is a main bridge which takes you through to the Antakarneri beach. So, saying about this location, it is equidistant from Kochi as Alappuzha, around 30 kilometers from Kochi as well as Alappi region. So if you come by Kochi, you can come by two ways. Same way, if you come from Alappi side or the Alappuzha side, you can come two ways. One is the coastal road, one is the main NH, National Highway 66. So if you are taking the National Highway 66, come to the Padmakshi Junction. After Thuravur, be cautious to look for the Padmakshi Junction. And just from there comes westwards. Westwards, you have to come around 3 kilometers or 4 kilometers, you will reach here. If you put in the Google map, you can definitely get this location, and it's very easy to come. And if you come by the coastal route, straight away from Fort Kochi or the Kochi side, you can straight away drive. It's a straight drive. There is no turns left or right. You will come and reach here. So around 30 kilometers from Kochi, as well as if you're coming by Alappi side from the south, then also again Padmakshi Junction in the NH66, and straight away to the west side, it takes 4 kilometers. And the view, the roads are very awesome. The view, the commuting view also is very awesome. So it's worth to come here and to spend your time because this area is very beautiful. This location gives you a refreshing time for you and your family. And this area doesn't have any entry fees, just parking slot that charge 20 rupees for your four-wheeler. That's it. So let's go to the entrance side, and I think there are some fish market which is organized in this daytime, in this morning. So this location is also a place for some movies also. The people, different Malayalam movies house also has some songs filmed over here. So in that location, I think Hariharan Pilla happy aanu, a movie star, Malayalam movie star, the famous movie star Indrajit has been here, and I was like amazed by to see him really, because he has a very tall personality and very handsome. So that's the potential of this area. There are a lot of films which was shoot or filmed over here, a lot of wedding locations, wedding, post-wedding and pre-wedding photography has been happened over here, but still it's not taken its entirety. Right now also this can be utilized for any destination wedding kind of things, but what to do? People or the authorities doesn't want to make money out of it or take generate money for the government. So this is the pathetic condition of the Kerala tourism. Even though Kerala is famous for the tourism industry, but there are a lot of locations like this which is underutilized or misutilized or mismanaged. It's also said that this area was a main port center in 13th century or around 12th century. I'm not exactly sure about the dates, but it was a main port center. The ships that time, the ships with the windshields that used to harbor here, and the Portuguese and many other traders from China and other part of this, the world come to here for the trading. But later on, after there was some kind of floods which has destroyed this area, the sea has taken almost 5 kilometers inside. So after that, when British came, the port has been relocated to the Cochin side, because that was a particular perfect location for a port. So they has even they have considered a artificial island for the shipyard, the Cochin shipyard, which is on the Willington Island. Willington, Lord Willington, the Viceroy, the Madras Presidency's Viceroy, Lord Willington's name is given to that island itself. So it is artificially made island in the big island in India. So the port has shifted to that area. So obviously this area get neglected, and there was no development after that. But now this is coming under the tourist mark of Kerala tourism, and it is getting a place of its own in the tourist industry, and is one of the best beach of Alappi or the Alappuzha district. But the facilities for the tourists who come over here, it's not that pleasantable, or there is nothing we can say there is any facility provided from the government. Before COVID, there used to have a lot of restaurants and small tea vendors which cater to the needs of the tourists come over here. But right now, after COVID, now everything is restricted. Even the entry to the beach is still not under consideration for the government. Actually, I can see a police aid post here, but it's closed. But maybe in the daytime, from 9 a.m. or 10 a.m., it will start functional. So this is a good thing that at least there is someone to look after in the daytime. But unfortunately, there is nobody to look this area in the nighttime. So this is the parking slot. If you come by your four-wheeler, you can get your cars parked here. And this is the main entrance. So this is Antakarneri Beach. There are one or two homestays also here. You get rooms for the cheap rates. I'm not sure, I haven't inquired, but I can see boats over here. So there are so many homestays. So these are people who are going for the fishing walks. So they are getting into the walk and moving to the Kochi side probably. And here is the fish market, you can see. but it's almost over. Every fish is taken away. And this is some kind of a small stalls for the dress. This was a fish market, but it's over right now. When I came here, I have seen people selling the fish here. So this is a wholesale area which they sell the fish, and they will go to the inside of the places here and sell it in retail. So that's a new bridge which was constructed to get the connectivity to this area. So the coastal road I was saying about is, well, that's area we can go to the Alappi side, and from that side, if you come, that's from the NH66 National Highway. So this is the old shutter or the old bridge which we used to connect. So this is the shutter which restrict the entry of the salt water from the sea to this lake. So this is the same kind of shutter we have seen in the last vlog also in Tannir Mukham Bund. We have this kind of shutters. That's in a big or a huge one. This is just a small one. But this is the main thing which protects the crop, the paddy cultivation around in that area, to the Vettakal or the Chembaga Padam and all that region. So there are a lot of Chinese fishing nets. You can see this area get a good catch of the fishes because this is just close proximity to the sea. So this is a beautiful view also from this area. It's a very cloudy day, that's why we are not getting enough light. That otherwise it will be a beautiful view over here. So this is the railings which hold that shutter, and right now it's closed. So the entry of the salt water to that area is being restricted. Right. Feeling hungry, so let me see whether I can get something from this restaurant. Chai and red. All the morning snacks are empty here. So there is a homestay advertisement here, beach homestay, and so just note this mobile number, and there is social media handles also given here, so anybody interested, you can go. So this is the second bridge which connects to the Kochi side. It's under construction, it's not fully operational, but the other one which have just we crossed here, that is operational from a long time. So this is just opposite side of the beach which is constructed by the government. This is an under constructed area, but free for everyone to come. Even this COVID lock time also, people can come over here and have the enjoy this beach location. So there are a lot of fishing boats are also lying over here. One is drowned. There is a small temple having the prayer chantings. It's very awesome to listen to this kind of prayer chantings in the early morning. Gives you a very pious outlook for the entire day. Sun is trying to come out of the clouds, but the dark clouds is not allowing it. The bridge is very huge, enough for two buses to pass. So that's another shutter which we were talking about to restrict the salt water entering that lake. So across that also we can see a lot of Chinese fishing nets. Just we can see a KSRTC bus flying out here. So the connectivity which I was saying is well connected. This bus is going to Chertala from this side. Chertala is a town over here, just 10 to 15 kilometers from this side. So coming to this area is not a big deal. You have enough transportation systems available. So here is a toy shop as well, just on the way to Andaganeri Beach. So it's also very located in a beautiful location, the scenic way of this bridge, and that's the toy shop. So once, if you want to get boosted up, you can try the Kerala's national drink, the toy, as well. This is an old kind of shop we can see over here. In North India we get the gutka, the chewing tobacco and all. So this uncle is making that kind of preparation. It's with the betel leaf. So this is typical soda. And this is called chakna, the moongphali or the groundnuts. So very interesting to see this kind of views, because nowadays we are just becoming, this kind of shops are becoming just very rare. So amongst this greenery we are getting this kind of views. It's quite eye catching. So this is a paddy field cultivation area. It's a very vast acres and acres, you can see. It's Chembakasheri Padam, you can say. And when you come from the Padmakshi Junction, when you're commuting through the NH66 to reach the Andaganeri Beach, so you will be coming through this way. So this is a very scenic location, or the way you are reaching. You can have a beautiful view of this entire area while commuting to the Andaganeri Beach way there. So it's around 2 kilometers in stretch in this area, and it's quite incredible. The Kerala's beauty can be seen over this. So if you're coming from Alappi side, or if you're coming from Kochi side, you took the turn, the west turn from Padmakshi Junction, and you will come over through this area. So I'm just flipping the camera. You can see some kind of artistic work, even is it a bottle art. The bottles are kept hanging over this tree. It's giving a quite incredible look. Now the bottles are filled with water, that's why it's not shaking. Otherwise when the wind comes, it gives a shaking look, so it gives a good look for the ambience to spend the time over here. Any evening time, although this is I think the morning walk or the evening walk area, the people used to walk because this is a long stretch without any disturbances, because in the early hours or the evening hours there will be less traffic. So I thought of sharing this view with you guys as well, because it's quite incredible. So that's it. We can see a lot of commuters with the bicycles as well. So fast. That's nice. So let's end this video because it's getting too lengthy, and I think I covered the entire stretch of the Antakanari beach, and I hope you guys have enjoyed this video, this beautiful scenery, this location, the aspects, the positive and negative sides of this area, and as well as a brief history of this location. So it's a very huge potential area which is very underutilized. I hope by seeing this, or the government or anyone from the official who can take a decision on this area will wake up and do something for this area to fully utilize its potential, because I think it's more beautiful than the Kochi port or the Fort Kochi area, because this is naturally made kind of estuary and the lagoons, and this area, this easy accessibility which is catering to the tourist or the relaxing or the refreshing needs of the Alappuzha people and in and around Kochi people. This is quite important to develop this area, apart from the monetary aspect. So Tijin signing off for the day. We'll come out with a beautiful location in the next vlog. I'm not taking any time frame because of the lockdown in Kerala. So whenever we get a chance, and when there is a sunny day, we'll go out and explore a much beautiful area than this of Kerala. So take care, and if you like this video, please consider subscribing to my channel, Tiju's Vlog, and bye bye. See you in the next vlog.